हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द प्रोग्राम टू ऐड टू मैट्रिसेस। लेट्स बिगिन। फर्स्ट वी हैव द प्रोग्राम कोड विद अस। आई विल वॉक यू थ्रू द कोड वंस, देन वी विल ब्रेक डाउन द कोड एंड डिस्कस इट इन डिटेल। सो हियर्स द प्रोग्राम कोड। वी विल स्टार्ट विद द हेडर ऑफ द प्रोग्राम hash include stdio.h. Then we will start the main program with integer main parentheses. Then first of all we will declare the variables that we require for the program. So we have integer I, j, rows, columns, a matrix A size 10 by 10, a matrix B size 10 by 10, and we have another matrix addition of size 10 by 10. Then we will input the number of rows and columns. So we have statements to input the number of rows and columns. After that, we have to take the input of all the elements of first matrix and the second matrix. So first of all, we will go through the input for the first matrix. So we have a for loop that states for rows equals to 0, rows less than I, rows plus plus. And then there is another nested for loop for columns equals to 0, columns less than j, columns plus plus. Then we have input statement for the rows and columns. So scanf percentage d comma and a rows columns. Similarly, we have to take the input for the second matrix. So we have another similar nested for loop for that. So in this, we will take the input for the matrix B. Then we have another nested for loop to store the sum of the corresponding elements in the matrix A and matrix B in the another matrix addition. So we have a for loop for that stores addition rows columns equals to matrix A row column plus matrix B row column. So after storing the sum in the addition matrix, we will display the addition matrix. So we have a similar nested for loop for that. So in this nested for loop, what we have is the print statement. So printf percentage d slash t addition rows columns, and in the end we will return an integer element. Now that we have seen the code, let us discuss it in detail. So here's the code breakdown. We have declared three two-dimensional arrays A, B and addition of size 10 by 10. Below statements ask the user to enter the matrices sizes. So these are the statement that will take the input for the size of matrices A and B. Next, we have used for loop to iterate each cell present in say A 2 by 3 matrix. Now conditions inside the for loop, rows less than I and columns less than j, will ensure the C programming compiler does not exceed the matrix limit. Otherwise, the matrix will overflow. The scanf statement inside the for loop will store the user entered values in every individual array element, such as A00, A01, A02, A10, A11, and A12. So here's the nested for loop that contains rows and columns as loop variables and the scanf statement percentage d and a rows columns. Now the next for loop in the matrix addition program is to store the user entered values in say B 2 by 3 matrix. Now in the next program line, we have one more for loop to perform addition. So here's the addition for loop. So in this for loop, we have the addition matrix that will store the corresponding sum of elements in A matrix and B matrix. Now next, the j value will increment. After the increment, the condition inside the second for loop, that is columns less than 3, will fail. So it will exit from the loop. Now the values of rows incremented, that is rows will become 1, and it starts the second row iteration. At last, we have used another for loop to print the addition matrix. So here's the for loop to print the addition matrix that contains the printf statement percentage %d/t addition rows columns. Thank you, students.